let me show you how to add branching logic to Microsoft Forms. So fall back to my desktop right now. Welcome to Jotform. My name is George, and on this video, I'm going to show you how to add branching to your Microsoft Form, also known as conditional logic. Now, in this case, I am located in Microsoft Forms, and if you are located in a different section, go ahead and click on this top menu on the left and go ahead and search for Forms and go to the Forms section. That'll take you right here. Now, we're going to get started with a form I pre-built with a template, and we are going to start branching from this form. Now, it's crucial to know that branching needs to be done when you finish building your form questions. So in this case, this is a form that has been finished, and we can now get started with branching. Unfortunately, branching doesn't work completely when you do it afterwards, okay? So in this case, we are located in the form builder. I can go ahead and click on the first question. I'm going to click on the first question, and there's an option here that has to be dots for settings for this question. And we are going to select add branching. And this is going to kick off the branching options. Be aware that we are located in the branching options section. So all of these questions now have a section like this. So for example, now I can see here that there's a go-to for each one of the selections. And if I select this one, the go-to pop-up will show here. What I can do is jump to certain sections of the form depending on the selection. So it's going to branch from this question, okay? So first off, if someone selects very satisfied, I can take them to a different section of the form. So right now it's currently selected to next. That means it's gonna jump to the next question and so on and so forth. But if they select very satisfied, I can take them to a certain section. For example, how do you agree with the following statements? So I can select this one. That means that it's going to skip question 2 and question 3, and it's going to jump to question 4 by selecting very satisfied, and the rest stay as they are. But I can do this for every single one of the selections. So I can say for satisfied, I'm going to do the same thing. For dissatisfied, I'm going to take them to, for example, did the course meet your expectations? And the last one, I'm going to leave it to jump into the next one just to continue as it is, just to give you an idea how this works. Now that is for the first section. I can do this with any one of these sections. Now these are fantastic to use because, for example, if this was an RSVP form for a party invitation and you want to ask them if they are going to attend or not, and if they are not going to attend, you can go ahead and just end the form. There is no need to respond to the next questions, and that could be a useful situation. And if they respond yes, then it continues with the question. So it's just an idea of how you can use this. Now, there's options like going into the next question, there's an option to end the form, and there's the option to jump to any of the other questions available here. The reason that you have to do branching when you are done building the form is because if you are going to jump to, for example, question number 8 and you haven't created it, then that there's a conflict with that already. So you want to do this when you finish your form, okay? So that's just a quick idea of how you can use branching. Let's go ahead and test it out right now to show you how this is going to perform. So let's go back. Let's go ahead and preview this form, and we are going to click on, for example, very dissatisfied, and that will continue with the next question. So if I click yes, remember, we are going to continue to the next question as normal. But if I click no, that will end the form and I'm going to submit. So like the example that I gave you, where if yes, they will attend, you continue to the next questions. And if not, you can just go ahead and submit this to let them know that you're not going to attend. An example of how you can use branching. So for example, if I use dissatisfied, that'll take me to the next branching that I've set. And that's how you can use branching here on Microsoft Forms. Now you'll also notice that there's a little branch right here, and that lets me know that I've enabled this on this form. Now, if you want to remove this, just go ahead and go back to edit, go to add branching, and just switch everything back to next and next and next. And that will turn it to the normal form again without branching. So it's a simple way to add conditional logic to your Microsoft Forms. But if you need more flexibility and you want more conditional logic options, then I do recommend that you jump into Jotform and you try it out. So for example, if I go to create a brand new form, and I'm gonna use a template for this purpose so you understand how it works, there's way more flexibility and you don't have to wait for the form to be built to use conditional logic. You can use it at any time you want. So right now I have this preview form, and to use conditional logic, I am going to go to settings, I'm gonna go to conditions, and this is where I can use conditional logic, or as Microsoft names it, branching. Now in conditional logic, there's several available options. You can show and hide a field depending on the answer. And let me give you a quick example right here. So for example, if how did you hear about us equals to, for example, one of the options that I have available in the drop-down menu is internet, I can go ahead and hide certain fields. So for example, I can go ahead and hide the feedback about us, and that's just hiding one of the elements. But if I want to hide multiple, I can do so by selecting hide multiple, and I'll just select what I want to hide. For example, the feedback, or this one and this one. So I've hidden three in this case. I'm going to save it just to give you an idea how this works. So for example, I'm going to preview the form. Here we go. I'm going to fill everything out, for example. And then how did you hear about us? If I select magazine, everything is normal. Here we go. All the questions are here. But if I select internet, you can see that we've hidden some of the fields. And conditional logic is super useful and practical to use right here. There's also the option to update and calculate fields. So for example, if you need to do a sum of certain sections, you can do so here. You can enable required or masked fields. So for example, depending on the response, you can make other questions required. If they were not required, you can make it required depending on the response that they said here. You can skip to or hide a page. So for example, if this is conditional logic, it can skip or hide a page. Change the thank you page. So depending on the response, you can change the thank you page. Maybe it's a satisfaction form, and if they were not satisfied, you can change the thank you page to take them to another section, or say sorry for not being up to the standards that they required. And by this, you can change right here. So for example, if the feedback about us is bad, then what you can do is show a custom message. So that changes the thank you page right here. So you can say sorry for not being up to your standards, and it gives you an idea of how you can use this. Or redirect them to your URL. So if you want to take them to a special coupon, a special sales page, that is possible through the redirect them to a URL. And the next option is change email recipient. So again, depending on the question, the response, the selection, you can change the recipient right here. And you can also run an integration based on the conditional logic set. So several available options for conditional logic here on Jotform. So that is how you are able to use branching on Microsoft Forms. So if you're looking to use branching, it's super easy to do so right here. Just don't forget to make your form first and then use branching. And if you want to use the alternative, there's a Jotform alternative. Please let me know here in the comments what you think about Microsoft branching and what you would like to see in the future. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that little bell notification to get notified when new videos come out. And that is a wrap.